Ahead of your vote 2014, we are putting these political ads that you've seen on TV through a truth test. Tonight, Congressman Rick Nolan is under attack by Republicans for his vote against funding for the war on terror. Our political reporter Tom Hauser has a grade from the latest ad, and this ad comes from the National Republican Congressional Committee.
We all know the growing threat we face today.
Are they coming for us?
They are actively working to come for us.
The latest Republican attack ad on Democrat Rick Nolan plays on the renewed fears we have of terrorism because of the threat posed by ISIS.
ISIS is no longer some fringe terrorist group.
The ad says, as a member of Congress, Nolan cast a very controversial vote.
What we don't know is why Congressman Rick Nolan voted to release terrorists held at Guantanamo Bay.
This is partially true, but also misleading. Congressman Nolan did vote in June against an amendment that would prohibit the use of funds to transfer or release terrorists held by the U.S. at Guantanamo Bay. In other words, Nolan favors using funds to move suspected terrorists from Guantanamo Bay to custody elsewhere, but not to set them all free. Nolan joined 173 Democrats and 10 Republicans voting against the amendment. Although it did pass, and prisoners are still held at Guantanamo.
And then voted against funding for our troops fighting the war on terror.
This is mostly true. In a series of amendment votes in May and June, Nolan voted to repeal the military force authorization that allows the president to use all necessary and appropriate force to go after those responsible for 9/11. He also voted to prohibit funds for U.S. combat operations in Iraq and made a statement supporting his vote on the House floor.
It is time to get out and to stay out.
Rick Nolan voted. Now it's our turn.
Because this ad includes mostly true information that is just partially misleading, it gets a B-plus on the truth test. Tom Hauser, 5 Eyewitness News.
Some of Nolan's votes came before ISIS became an increasingly major threat. However, President Obama has used the military force authorization that Nolan voted against as justification for going after ISIS. Also, just last week, Nolan voted against authorizing aid to Syrian opposition to help fight ISIS. But so did Republican Michelle Bachmann. Bachmann said that the Obama administration isn't going far enough. Nolan thinks that President Obama is going too far.